Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Asad Lalji. I'm the curator here at the Royal Opera House. On behalf of the Royal Family of Gondal, Ashish Doshi, Honorary Director, and myself, welcome to a very special evening. We've been revived as India's only surviving opera house over 3 years ago, and in this new chapter of our history, we've dimensionalized our programs to showcase the breadth of the arts, performing arts, visual arts, literature, design, and so much more from across the country and across the world. At the Opera House, literature is considered one of our most important verticals, and we are constantly striving to bring new perspectives and voices to our audiences. The Opera House has staged and contributed to supporting literature in all its forms through its robust and out-of-the-box programming. We regularly collaborate with literature festivals, publishing houses, authors, intellectuals, and important thought leaders to give the city events that be long remembered. Our programming also includes and supporting the wonderful art of comedy. The Royal Opera House has been a platform for a number of leading stand-up comedians and hosted festivals on this very stage. Tonight, we're very happy to partner again with Penguin Random House, with whom we've launched several books for their eminent authors. And this evening, we're honored to have yet another remarkable voice to add to this repertoire. So without further ado, Penguin Random House, India, Landmark Books, the Royal Opera House, Mumbai, and Avid Learning present the official Mumbai launch of Milind Soman's memoir, Made in India, and a comedy roast of the book by comedian Cyrus Broacha to celebrate this milestone. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Milind Soman and Cyrus Broacha, along with Rajesh V. of Landmark Books, to officially launch the book here. Thank you. Congratulations, Milind. Over to you, Cyrus, and have a wonderful evening. Thank you, guys.
All right, thank you, Asad. Wow, my chest is speaking, excellent. Okay, listen, this is a very informal show. I have to apologize, I'm not even wearing underwear. And as you can see, we are two so-called artists who don't even wear shoes. So the BJP will be proud. What kind of audience are you? We can make fun, right? All right, okay. Mangalam from CNBC, you're a bot man, come on. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is first let me introduce everybody. He's probably the best looking man in India, artist, anchor, actor, enough about me. There's also Milind Soman. I want you to give a minute to Milind Soman because... my mother, mom, where are you? Just put your hand up. My mother, we used to swim actually at the YMCA with Mr. Sate. I don't know if you remember all this. Otters was later, Milind. Alzheimer's is a major problem, so. Bear with us. We used to swim. My mom would drive that lovely ambassador car. Do you remember the ambassador car, any of y'all? Yeah, so it has gears which bodybuilders have to operate. And if you press the brake here in Opera House, it stops in Parel. It's like that. And this young man, we were 6, 7 years my senior, my sister and me would be in the car with my mother, and my mother's Hindi was exposed. Mom, remember when the car would stop and you'd ask some gentleman to piche se dabao mere ko and all that? All this scarred this young man, who came from England, struggling with both Hindi and Marathi, and then had to fit in Shivaji Park as the tale will unfold. But so we go back a long way, and my mom, give her a hand, is the first lady, well, first find out why, the first lady who actually said how good looking Milind was. And I was very upset, because I'm sitting there and nobody says anything about me. You know, he's such a good look, he's telling my sister, he's such a good looking young man and all that. You know, so it goes back. So mom, you're the person who spotted him first before Rasna Bell and all these professionals. And that 10% we are still to receive, by the way. All right. Now that we are sitting in Ramdev's chairs, so I can start yoga at any point. This is the contraceptive I use. I have 2 children, thanks to that. Yeah, it's that kind of cheap show. But let's not take away from the man. I've read the book. I read the whole book. And let me start, before we say anything, I have to mention this. The book, it says right at the top, is written by Milind Soman. It's that big. And then Rupa Rai is that small.
By
Rupa Pai. See, I can't even see it. That small. I said Rai instead of Pai. All right. So here's the point. Who wrote the book? Rupa or you? I mean, Rupa wrote the book. So what did you do exactly? You lay on your back and...
I told her what to write.
So you did commentary, basically. You didn't actually pick up a pen even once. And you call yourself a writer and a memoir. How do we know what you're saying is true? I mean, you're sitting there lying down. You're just talking to a tape, I suppose? A phone? Into her ear. By the way, you need a mic. I've just been told by the third person sitting in fourth row there. Yeah, it's a scientific thing, Milind, where you use the mic and then the sound is enhanced and people can... It's on.
Hello.
It's on. Are you on, Mr. Supermodel? That's the question. We thank all your modeling fraternity who are in the upstairs balcony section. Since their careers are plummeting, they will be jumping out any moment now. He, like Amitabh Bachchan, actually, that's a great parallel, are the only ones who have survived. Milind is still there. He's relevant. You see him everywhere. I just saw hoardings of him during the marathon or something or the other. So he survived for 40 years. You're amazing. You're better than the Congress at the moment. I mean, wow. And a bit younger. All right. So first question. Rupa Pai writes everything. Well, you did absolutely nothing. And I now come. I've read the book. I cannot lie. I have read every word of that book. I liked everything except the running. I hated the running. The running just goes on. He keeps telling you he's running. You know, I mean, we understand that you're running throughout the book, but it's a nice touch, I guess. Now, I'm beginning with this question. We are friends, but I don't want to be hostile. It's a fun show and all that, but it irritated me. Right there on page 3, 4, or 5. How can a person who is down to earth call himself down to earth? You see, I don't understand that, because you're not down to earth. You're in fact boasting about being down to earth. So how are you down to earth if you're saying, I'm down to earth? So that just threw me. So please explain to this August audience in the month of March, why are you down to earth? And if you really are down to earth, how dare you say you're down to earth? It's like saying, I'm a generous man. I mean, it's just wrong. You don't say, excuse me, don't leave. It's page 1. Arjun Rampal, come back here, you complex man. Arjun Rampal, folks. Still living in the shadow of this great man. I apologize. Unnecessary. He's a lovely guy. Are you friends?
He's a lovely guy. Arjun's a lovely guy.
No, don't hide. Are you and Arjun friends?
Yes, very much.
Very quickly, we'll segue for a second. Who are you friends with out of that whole lot, the John Abrahams and Dino Moria and all these guys?
All of them.
You're still in touch?
No.
Were you the alpha model?
No. Yes.
So they would follow you?
I guess.
Oh. Down to earth?
Down to earth.
My foot. Down to earth. Amazing. Well, how can he do that? It's like Kim Jong-un writing a memoir. I was a great humanitarian. So what if I kill my uncle 7 times? Oh. All right. Bet you haven't got that analogy in a long time. Yeah. Okay. Then we go on. Now he says he's from Shivaji Park. His story starts in England. You want to tell us a little bit about that? You were born in England, is it? And he spent 7 years there in England. English was the first language.
Yes.
And then he went to Shivaji Park, and he very proudly calls himself a man from Shivaji Park. But he doesn't play cricket. You don't even like cricket. You mentioned it's just not one of the... You didn't even understand LBW till you were 21.
Yeah.
What's that story?
I prefer swimming, no?
There's no pool in Shivaji Park.
There is?
MGMO.
Yeah.
That's technically not Shivaji Park, but I don't want to argue.
Oh, right. So it's technically not a pool.
So just one sec. You never played cricket? While the boys are playing in the locality and all those pitches are there, there are only 2 things in Shivaji Park that you have to do. Either you play cricket or join the Shiv Sena. I don't know what you're doing. He's not being clear about all this. Why hide facts? So you didn't like cricket at all?
You missed the RSS?
I'm coming to the RSS. And let me tell you, young man, Shiv Sena and RSS are not the same thing. They may shop at the same tailor, because... But it's not the same thing. We'll come to that. There he has been candid. You're rushing away with your own story. I want to let them...
Sorry.
It's like a trailer, so people actually read the whole book. Yeah. Otherwise, it's just about the run, huh? So just if you cut to the run, he's just running all the time. Okay. On page 5, 6, 7, 8 in Roman, which means the damn story's not started. I hate books which have these Roman numericals. You read and read, page 1 hasn't come. I mean, he's already a model, and we're still on like 19 in Roman numericals. But you say on page 8, and I'm quoting, life has been a struggle for you, has not been a struggle for you. Unlike Adolf Hitler, you know, who wrote a book about struggle. But that's another story. But for you, no struggle. Okay? So can you just tell us a little bit about that? What do you mean by you've never had any struggle? That's a fabulous answer, Milind.
Yeah, thank you.
He really is a model. I mean, that's enough. So what are you going to get, folks, is a lot of looks, okay? And you're going to have to translate it yourself. All right. What was that? Look number 75.
Yeah. Or 750.
So what do you mean by no struggle? Now, come on, tell us.
I'm not supposed to be talking.
But stop scratching. I would have got my Doberman and you could have done the same thing. Yeah. So what the hell is no struggle? Everybody struggles. You didn't struggle at all?
Not at all.
You've never felt bad or felt pushed or
no,
that never, life is never. Against you?
Never.
Not even when that court case happened?
Especially then.
You felt great?
Yeah.
Can't say the same for poor Madhu. But, that's true. What was your fascination? What is your fascination with breaststroke? Why did you choose? There are four strokes. There's backstroke, there's freestyle, there's butterfly, there's breaststroke. Why did you go for breaststroke? And let me look at your mother.
I was good at it.
But why did you choose the others? The
because more I was good
strokes?
At breaststroke.
Right from the beginning?
Right from the beginning.
All right. Who was your biggest rival in swimming? You don't even remember. What a vain, egotistical, down-to-earth man he turned out to be. He can't remember a rival, four-time national champion. Not one name comes to mind. Now, I must ask your mom, since she's sitting there, and the ladies may want to know, you are from the generation we swam together, so I remember, who wore the Speedo.
Yes.
The Speedo leaves nothing to the imagination. It's basically it's a handkerchief. It's a handkerchief, and you wear it around your cross. Delicate area, yeah. And then you swim. Do you still wear Speedos, or have you moved on? So you don't wear anything? What do you wear? The moment you said you don't wear Speedos, two women are walking out. I'm not lying. It's just left for some reason. So what do you wear when you swim now?
Shorts.
Milind Mike. Milind Mike. Half the interview. We've got the looks. When he doesn't look, he puts the mic forward for some reason.
Shorts.
Yeah. All right. Doesn't want to answer that either. This is a very interesting point. You're a senior card-carrying member of the RSS. You joined at the age of 7.
I'm not a senior.
Now, only Mohan Bhagwat is above him in the hierarchy. Take us through how, why the RSS. And at the this is in the book, I'm not lying, underlined. Huh? So
she knows about it.
I know. So tell them, but they don't know. They, you know, nobody knows this side to you.
It's in the book.
I know it's in the book, but just give us an insight. I'm on the side of the grandmother from England. I've had enough.
So in Shivaji Park, you know, a lot of the children did join the RSS when they were kids, just like a play group.
Okay, yeah. And then in your adulthood, did you carry on?
No.
So you call the RSS a play group?
When I was a child, yeah.
So like when we went to Ashok's house and played with the dog or something, you wore short pants and marched around Shivaji Park.
I did.
And that was fun.
Who's Ashok?
Ashok is my neighbor. My story is worse. I do it now. You were 7, it's different. So any political affiliations? None? It was just the way it was in Shivaji Park at that time. And then after that, what did you do? Did you follow them at all or you just...
No, then I started swimming and that's all I did.
You left that. Yeah. So can we quickly have a little insight into your political affiliations now? How does Milind vote? Would you like to know? Yeah. You'd like to know.
But I'm not supposed to say.
No, why not? Your book is to... You have to open up and tell us. That's why they're $499 for looks. They can just go on Insta. Come on. Tell us a little bit. What a Milind Soman. There are a lot of people here. How many people here really admire him? Come on, because he's got a great body of work. He's shifted careers from acting to modeling, and he's still at it. He's a fitness, not he's like an icon for, like a brand ambassador for the country when it comes to fitness. And he's still, you know, women still go crazy when they see him, a few men as well. So, with a lot of respect, what is your political affiliation? I can't lie more than this.
I think it's not with any particular party, but with politicians who I think might be doing good work.
See, those 7 years in England taught him how to handle people. Not one straight answer has happened so far. No commitment whatsoever. I feel very bad for Ankita. I'm very scared. Really. Be careful. By the way, she says you have OCD.
She trusts me.
No, she told me you have OCD and are very difficult to live with, right?
When did you speak to him?
I've done a lot of research. I'm sweating here. I've worked really hard. I wish somebody else comes to the party. Ankita, difficult to live with, right? Slightly difficult?
She loves it. Down to earth.
Do you live with your mother?
Yes.
So do I. But with my mother, not your mother. Good Indian men. Our women deserve better, really. Mom, we've got a wife, you can rest now. Nothing changed. No need his book for that. Yeah. All right. What about the other, the wild parties and the things like that? You said everybody's experimenting. They all...
I didn't.
This is an 80s subculture which people want to know. I mean, if you could just tell us a little bit.
Experimenting with drugs.
Drugs, sex, the whole thing, it comes together. Did he come home late a lot?
Yeah.
In the 80s? Yeah. Was he?
Drunk.
Yes.
Yeah? How did you handle it?
She was upset.
Did you give him the lecture?
No. No lecture.
Did he? And he used to bring people home as well?
No.
Never?
Never.
Okay. So you didn't actually take anybody home, even by mistake. All right. Ankita, you're the first. Huh. What? But okay. It's a more intelligent question than I'm making it out to be. What's fascinating for you, the great Adonis of our times? What do you like about women?
Well,
take your time and answer.
Yeah, well,
nothing primal, please. They expect a very intellectual, emotional.
Well, the fact that the inspiration is, of course, that we know that women for generations, for thousands and thousands of years, because of the patriarchal society that we have been assigned a particular role. You wanted intellectual, right?
No, this is the worst
you,
answer.
Come on, you
this
told
is like a Miss India.
You told me.
I'm in the semifinals
but
now.
But you asked for it.
What's going
you
on
You said
here?
Nothing primal.
Mother Teresa starts dropping out of everywhere.
I just love women.
She just wanted a nice, you didn't a little poetic
it.
Answer. Okay, saying, I like girls, okay.
I just
do this, do that.
Love everything about them.
Oh.
Thank you.
The book is a work of fiction. Made in India. No, I'm kidding. All right, so let's give him a big hand.